Well, hello, my fellow light explorers. Today, I'm back at Toadstool Hoodoos to try and catch Comet NEOWISE. I too tried to photograph Comet NEOWISE, and I came here around 3 days ago to try and photograph NEOWISE in the morning, but unfortunately it was too low and hidden behind those cliffs right there. That's northeast. So now, knowing that NEOWISE is an evening comet too, I came here today to try and find some composition that might work for photographing the comet. I had come here 3 days ago to photograph Comet NEOWISE, and I set up my camera and I had my lens pointing in that direction, which is northeast, and the intent was to get the Toadstool Hoodoos in the foreground and the comet somewhere above Toadstool Hoodoos. But unfortunately for me, the cliffs were too high as compared with the elevation of NEOWISE, because now early morning it's really low and it was probably hidden behind those cliffs. So today I've come here with the intent to shoot NEOWISE in the evening, because the elevation is supposed to be quite high and that's northwest right there. So NEOWISE should be coming and setting in this direction, going below the horizon and then rising in the northeast tomorrow morning. So hopefully I am able to find the right location to photograph NEOWISE today, and I'm able to see NEOWISE in part because the elevation of NEOWISE is higher than it was in the morning 3-4 days ago. One dilemma I'm having right now is what focal length to use for NEOWISE, because I haven't seen the comet and I have no idea how big the comet really is. So if I use 24mm, which is what I'm inclined to use to get the foreground landscape and then NEOWISE in the background, it's possible that because of the exaggeration of that focal length, NEOWISE becomes really small and a tiny dot in the back, and I don't want that. So I'm thinking maybe I'll use 70mm of my 70-200 lens, and that's a good compromise between wide angle and telephoto. The only issue is, well, two things. One is that framing wise, I don't quite know where NEOWISE is going to be setting. So that's northwest, and I'm not sure where exactly it'll set. So I'll probably point my camera somewhere northwest, like 315, 320 degrees, and hope NEOWISE comes down and sets in that direction. The other issue is that I don't know if I'll get a sharp image front to back with 70mm and in one single exposure without focus stacking. So I'll probably have to focus stack. The third issue is that 70mm is way more than 14. So when I eventually at night shoot NEOWISE, I will have to be careful about the shutter speed, because I don't want any trails. So I'm thinking maybe I can't exceed 6 to 7 seconds would be my max. So let's see if I get that image at a high ISO of say 6400 and 6 seconds with the aperture open all the way to 2.8. Now that I'm using 70mm as my focal length, I've got to move all the way back and find a spot high enough so that my composition has the foreground and the background. In other words, there's enough space for the foreground and the background, because 70 millimeters will really sort of bring things in. And I looked around here, there are only rocks everywhere and these mounds. The only high ground is that hill up there, but honestly, only a fool would climb that hill. A fool? How clumsy of me. I meant a photographer. In terms of technique, this will be a dual exposure. So I will take the foreground very shortly once the sun sets. It's almost set right there. And maybe around 15-20 minutes after the sun sets, I'll take a shot of the foreground. I might take 4 or 5 shots to focus stack just in case. I will use an aperture of f16 for the foreground, so I should be getting acceptable sharpness from the front to the back, hopefully, we'll see. Otherwise, I'll have my focus stack shots anyway. And then I'll wait for a good like an hour and a half or so until Comet NEOWISE can be seen in the sky. There has to be like astronomical twilight around that time, dark enough skies to see NEOWISE. So once NEOWISE can be seen, and hopefully it is above those cliffs, once it comes down to set and it's above those cliffs in the location that I want it to be for my composition, I will take the shot. My shot would be having an exposure of about ISO 5000 or so, a shutter speed of around 5 or 6 seconds, and I will open the aperture all the way, f2.8. I will use my 7200 millimeter lens at 70 millimeters. So we'll see how it looks. Yeah, exciting. Let's wait and see and hope that NEOWISE shows itself today and I can get that shot. Search for Comet NEOWISE, and I'm back here at Toadstool Hoodoos. So you've seen my shot from yesterday of NEOWISE setting over the cliffs in the background, and today I came back to take another shot because I want something that's closer in the foreground. So something like maybe a hoodoo or two hoodoos in the foreground and the NEOWISE setting over those hoodoos, and hopefully I can use my telephoto lens, my 7200 at around 70 or 100 or 135 or whatever, to bring the comet closer and also have this compression of the perspective. A lot of you have pinged me and asked me about the wireless remote that I use on my camera, and it's a brand called, I think, SMDV, and this is the receiver. Not sure if you can see it, but it's really small, and the great thing is that it's got a range of 100 feet and also that it draws power directly from the camera. So you don't need to have a separate battery for the receiver. The transmitter looks like this. And it takes one AAA cell, which lasts forever. And so with this, I can actually go up to about 60, 70 feet, I checked myself, and it works just fine. The great thing is that you can trigger this camera from far away, and also it can be used for taking selfies, let's say against a waterfall, and you want to have a selfie against the waterfall. You can actually just go set your camera up with the right settings, and then take this trigger, go towards the waterfall, and take all the selfies you want without coming back every few seconds to reset or press the shutter release again if you're on the self-timer mode. We wait until dusk to shoot the foreground. There's some cloud cover, and I hope it's clear in the next 2-3 hours. The weather forecast did say that it'll clear by 9:30, and so far they've been accurate, because when I came here around an hour ago, it was completely overcast, and now it's clearing up. And so I'll take my foreground shot, and then 2 hours later, hopefully the clouds have gone, the sky is clear, the comet's in the right location, I'll shoot the comet. And I'll probably use an ISO of 5000, shutter speed of around 4 or 5 seconds, an aperture f2.8. My focal length is 135 millimeters, and that's cool today because yesterday's shot was cool too, but the cliffs and the comet were in the same plane, vertical plane, you know, at a distance. So there was no sense of perspective. Today I'm going to have the left side hoodoo on the left side of the frame and right in your face. And a little behind that will be the right side hoodoo at a distance. And then you'll have the white cliffs in the background and the comet setting above that. So it should be a cool shot. So I can't wait to show you the shot. Fingers crossed, things turn out well, and you will see the result of this crazy endeavor. Concludes this video, and I really hope you enjoyed it. If you liked it, then like, share, subscribe as always. And if you didn't like the video, that's okay too. Just leave me a comment down below letting me know how I can improve the videos going forward. Until next time, this is the Light Explorer signing out of beautiful Toadstool Hoodoos in southern Utah.